guys, welcome back to the next part of the video. I believe this is part 4. We're continuing on with this little section of fur up here. So I'm going to go back in with my cold gray 5 and really start to map the edge of the light gray versus the darker gray. So here I'm using a light pressure for this, not going in too dark, and gonna bring it here as well. So with this part, I know I will probably be going in with my craft knife afterwards and add some fur detail back in, but for now I just really want to get in the correct areas. So I'm not going all the way up to the edge of where the ear is, because there's actually a little bit more of the terracotta that I'm going to be adding in afterwards. So for now, I just want to get somewhat of the dark that I can see, and I'm slightly bringing it into the light areas now, again using light pressure. Using the light pressure can help if you make a mistake and you need to go in and erase it, then you can do that. If you went in too heavy-handed right away, then you're gonna have a harder time with lifting that color that you just put down. Alright, so I'm gonna work on this little flick here. So nice and gently and nice and carefully, just going on the edge of this light patch here. And then I went a little bit too thick with my nail dotting tool, but what's nice about the nail dotting tool is after a while you can kind of get the color to go into what you've embedded. Okay, we're gonna carefully flick the fur. I'm using longer strokes because the fur is definitely longer up here, and I'm also putting it into the other color that, well, the brown patch as well. Alright, so I know this section here is darker, so I can do shorter strokes closer together down here, and then afterwards I can go over with my knife and add any details that I think is needed. But for now, we'll do that. Kind of bring it up a bit. Okay, so dark there. That's dark there. So, that's a nougat. I don't want nougat. So I'm gonna go in with walnut brown a bit. And I see a little bit of a brown tone in this dark area that goes into the light gray. I think this will help the shadowed area here in the brown patch as well. Bring it down to into here and then slightly here as well. Now I think I've got a little bit too dark there, but that's okay. Go on and lighten it up with my knife afterwards. Okay, I'm gonna add a little bit up here as well. And here as well. I'm gonna go in with nougat next. Grab a warm gray. Okay, I'm going to go with a warm gray 3. Warm gray 3. And I'm just kind of feathering out the blunt line strokes. I'm gonna go back in with terracotta. Terracotta right here. And ivory once again. With the ivory, I'm taking it into the grays as well. I'm gonna clean it before I go down for the next layer. There we go. Payne's gray. Payne's gray is gonna go up in here as well. I accidentally went too hard in pressure there. That is okay. Down here too. Using the side of my pencil, I'm lightly going over. I'm just kind of glazing the color there. I'm not worried about detail, I just want to darken that area up a bit. And a little bit there. And I'm going to kind of flick this up. You can kind of start seeing it's coming together a little bit. Everything's starting to take shape. Then I'm going to go in with cold gray six. I'm gonna add a little bit more detail in this section here. Kind of using where I embedded the paper as my guidelines to where I want my light patches to be. going back in with terracotta. I'm gonna kind of do there. Sienna. All right, and back in with the cold gray 6. Just darken up there a bit again. Dark sepia. Again, I'm using dark sepia. And then let's see, let's do cold gray 3. Cold gray 3. And then a little bit of terracotta in this dark area up here. You know what? I'm gonna add some of this Caput Mortuum Violet, if that's how you pronounce it. I'll put it up on the screen if I haven't done so already in the last video. Okay, so I think I'm going to call it quits for this video. This video is going to be a little bit shorter than the rest, but I think I'm done drawing for one day. So if you haven't done so, please leave a comment down below. Subscribe.